everyone, it's Monica. So I'm back to share a quick project with you. So on Thursday and Friday of this past week, I actually participated in the live streams of Maggie White and Laurel, who is Forever Purple Creations here on YouTube. They host a live crafting stream every Thursday on Maggie's channel and every Friday on Laurel's channel. So I was able to participate in both, so I crafted on the panel with the rest of the ladies. I wanted to go ahead and just come in real quick and share what I created. I did work on something else on the live, which I'll share separately, but for this, I'm gonna go ahead and show them together. So I created some tags using the Graphic 45 regular tag and gears. So let's go ahead and quickly get into the products that I used and we'll move on to the tags. So like I just mentioned, I used the Graphic 45 regular tag and gears die. I used both dies from here. I used the regular black tag albums from Graphic 45. This is the staples. For my background elements, I went ahead and I did Distress Oxide backgrounds. So on one of the tags, I used Seedless Preserves, Wilted Violet, as well as Black Soot. For the second tag, I also used Black Soot. I used Walnut Stain, Wild Honey, and Peeled Paint. And for the element of the background, I also used the Distressed Resist Spray. And with the Distressed Resist Spray, I went ahead and sprayed it and I added Stampendous Detail Gold Embossing Powder on top. So let's go ahead and quickly get into the tag. Now, both tags that I created are very similar. There's only some slight differences in them because one I created on Thursday, I actually ended up giving away to one of the ladies on the live stream. And then Laurel wanted one. She wanted to win, so I went and I decided to create one for her the next day. So here is the first one that I created on Thursday night on Maggie's channel. And I will link both of the ladies' channels in the description box below in case you ever want to check them out. Again, Maggie goes live every Thursday, and she has other ladies on the panel. And Laurel goes on every Friday. So here is the tag that I created. So as you can see, I used the various colors of the Stress Oxide in the background. And I hope you can see my lighting. It's kind of late, so it might be a bit dark. So as you can see, the sporadic spray in the background with the embossing powder. Let me go ahead and bring it up some more. That is where I used the Distress Resist Spray and then sprinkled embossing powder on top. Here you have the gearish frame that comes with the die, the tag die. And all I did was I die cut it and then I just snipped off several portions of the die itself so it wasn't the full frame. As you see, you have empty space here. I cut some more out that were in the middle and then some down here. From there, after I adhered that down, I went ahead and I took some metal gears in various sizes and I layered them on the background. We have three in bronze and we have a second one layered on top here in silver and this one is in silver as well. On top of those layers, I added a copper filigree heart on top and then we have two bronze little wings on the sides. On the adjacent corners on the lower left and upper right, we have some small copper filigree corners there. And the bling that I use throughout the card is the Vitrell Medium. I believe it's also referred to as the rainbow color. In various sizes, it looks like I use SS16, SS12, possibly SS10 as well. And from the bottom, I dangled three metal tassels. We have two bronze on the outer portion, and then we have a copper one here. Here we have this large chunky chain for if the recipient wants to go ahead and hang the tag, or if they choose to display it differently, you can just lay it on the side of the tag and have it there. So this is the first tag that I created. Again, I did give this away on Maggie's Live, so this is going to be finding its new home. So for Laurel's, I went with a very, very similar theme. I just changed a few little elements to it. So this one I made with purple. Purple is Laurel's favorite color, so I wanted to go ahead and make it a little bit more accustomed to her. So for this one, I followed the exact same pattern. I did less cutting on the background. As you can see here, you have the open gap here, you don't. Same thing here at the bottom. I don't think I cut, well, no, I actually did. I can see that I cut out the middle portion of the die itself, but I left the background intact a little bit more than I did on this one. So for this one, I still have some gears on the background. I did change it up and I added this big clock here. And then we also have the swatch mechanism underneath the heart, but we do still have that same copper filigree heart in the center. For the corners, I went ahead and I swapped the corners. I put one on the upper left and one on the lower right. And we have eyelets, three on this side and three on the lower left. And from the bottom, I just decided to dangle this, what are these? Easier to say, it's a music note. I forgot what they're called. But I just decided to hang a single one from the bottom versus three tassels. Again, we have the same chunky chain on top so that she can use either to hang it by the chain or she can just loop it to the side. So here are the two tags that I created. I hope you enjoyed them. Let me know what you think. If you want a tutorial on how I did the Distress Oxide background with the resist spray, just comment below and let me know, and I'd be more than happy to film that for you. It's super easy. And that's about it. Again, let me know what you think. Comment below. And I will catch you guys in another video. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.